What's going on, man? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the basement. I'm Ron. It's hot as shit in New Jersey. I got two beams fucking coming down on me. So if I got sweat bullets coming down my forehead, that's why you know it's hot as a bitch in New Jersey. That's why I got the plain white tee with the dare. Don't do drugs, kids. Now, before we get into this video, make sure you go down below, subscribe, leave a like. Only 4% of you guys are subscribed. Only 4% of people that watch these videos are subscribed. So make sure you go down below. Hit the subscribe button. It's free. If at any point in time you fuck with this video, you fuck with the content, I'm sure that you'll fuck with the rest of my content. So stick around, man. And while you're down there, if you want my rookie rankings, if you want kind of a layout of how I look at these drafts, how I attack these drafts, check out the Patreon down below. I have my rankings and all that stuff down there.
Folding a big old red ass cheeks and long digging that pussy till it's squirting and farting, squirting and farting, squirting and farting. Got that dookie hole soaking wet.
Nigga, draw this one.
Oh, hit it! Okay, baby, be calling me Hercules, cause the H on my waist, but this bitch here stand for Hermes. Okay.
Alright, so before we get into this, let me take a little look at the squad. Let me give you a little MTV crib tour. Come through. Let me show you what we got going on here. We got Gardner Minshew at QB1. Psych. We have Russell Wilson at QB1, but Gardner Minshew at QB2 is a little bit concerning. I definitely want to, if I can get a QB in this draft, maybe at the 108, we get somebody like a Trey Lance. That could be dope as well. Now, my running backs are rock solid. We have Miles Sanders, J.K. Dobbins, Cam Akers. That's a solid trio. And then we also got Clyde Edwards-Helaire. I'm feeling good at the running back spot. I think the running back spot, we got some studs there. Then we got some decent wide receivers. Christian Kirk, Devontae Parker are pretty trash. But in terms of, like, up-and-coming guys, we got Ayuk, Chenault, Chark. We even got T. Higgins. So, the wide receivers are promising. But when I build these teams, so this team I built on a startup draft last year. And I pretty much tanked. I got, like, a bunch of young players. I traded back in the startup. And I just ended up going with a win-later type team. Let's just get draft picks. Let's go. That's how I got the first overall pick. I ended up trading the first overall pick. I traded the first overall pick in Matthew Stafford for Russell Wilson. The 108 and the 110. So I really like that move. I personally have Russell Wilson ahead of Trevor Lawrence, but if some of you guys out there disagree with me, let me know. Now, as I said, this was a team that wasn't built to win now, but when you're putting in this $20, $50, $100, $200 for these buy-ins, you're not trying to keep punting. Like I'm not a fan of like long-term rebuilds, like 3 years, 4 years. Most of you like inherit an orphan where shit's getting paid for you and the team was just trash. If I'm going to have like a team where I tank for the first overall pick, after I get that first overall pick, I'm going to start spinning and flipping and fucking ripping and dealing these fucking assets, all right? Now, with all that said, this rookie draft, obviously, I can't trade any of these picks, so I can't trade out of tiers. And I have plans to maybe move one of these first for like a legit stud. Maybe I bundle up like a first and a T. Higgins for an A.J. Brown. You know, that's just something like off the top of my head I could do, you know? But for the purpose of this, we're going to go through, like, I want to do, like, a proper rebuild, do all the rookie picks, and just kind of my thoughts when I'm on the clock. And we'll keep my roster on the side so we can look over at it during the draft, but let's get straight into it, as my boy B-Lou would say. All right, so start up the draft. We'll see who goes. We got Trevor Lawrence, Fields, Najee Harris, Trey Lance, Zach Wilson, and Jamar Chase. And Javonte Williams. Wow. If this actually happened when I'm on the clock, I would be screaming without the S. Just know that. I would have, dude, Travis Etienne, you got, all you OG subscribers out there that have my rookie rankings, that know my fucking rankings, Travis Etienne is my RB1. He's a tier one guy. Now, the scary part about the pick eight spot, if you're out there in a super flex league, you want a top seven pick. It sucks I have number eight, because top seven for me, there's a clear tier one. I think the clear tier one is in whatever order you want. Lawrence, Fields, Trey Lance, Zach Wilson, Najee Harris, Jamar Chase, and Travis Etienne. I personally don't have Javonte Williams in there. If you have Javonte Williams in there, fine. But then I probably have Javonte Williams in that next tier, because I think that Travis Etienne, Najee Harris are the only running backs with the upside to go like first round at this point. And I'm not sure how athletic Javonte Williams is. Travis Etienne, he ran like a 4.4 something. I've seen times where they have him at like 4.45, 4.4. You just have like 5 seconds. He runs in like that 4.45, 4.5 range. He's like 215. He's perfect, man. Might as well honestly pull this up real quick for you guys. Travis Etienne is a guy. I'm going to take a second here to really cape up for my boy Travis Etienne. Oh, there he is right there. Fifth on the popularity rankings on Player Profiler. None of these like really stand out, but he's 5'10", 215, has the size. 4'5 is great speed for a running back. really well in the passing game. He's just a do-it-all back, and at 215, he can literally do anything that you want him to. Best comparable to DeAndre Swift. So if you're telling me that you can get DeAndre Swift at the 108, when in reality, if you wanted DeAndre Swift, you probably have to pay the 101. They just brought in Jamal Williams. He's never going to be in a clear backfield. Or not that he's never going to be, but it's a little bit murky in that situation. And you can get ETN at the 108 in Superflex. GG. Give me that all day. Even though I don't even really need a running back. I really don't. I have Miles Sanders. I have J.K. Dobbins. But here's my general philosophy. If you want to get very philosophical with it. If you want to call me Aristotle, you know, Copernicus, anything among those lines. If you just want to put on your philosopher hat. My genuine idea is, let's say you're even strong at running back and you're four running backs deep, super strong at. I think it's okay. Seasonal, especially in Dynasty, just get best player available. But in Seasonal and Dynasty, I never care about having too much of one position as long as it goes through the flexes. I'm cool with having five starting running backs every week because I have three flexes there. I'm not going to sit here and say, okay, I have four really good running backs. I don't have any really good wide receivers. Why not force a wide receiver here? If you can start these running backs, like so in Seasonal, if you can get a third running back that's sick and you're like, oh, I don't have a wide receiver yet. If you can start that running back in the flex, it does not matter. As long as these running backs will not, as long as the player that you pick isn't just picking up dust on the bench, draft them regardless of position. That's quarterback, tight end, anything among those lines. Not tight end, because I would never put a tight end in the flex if it's like premium. But you guys get what I'm saying. All right, so Kyle Pitts goes. That means I am ultimately fucked at tight end. My tight end is Ian Thomas and Foster Moreau. Legitimate awful tight ends, but that's why you go best player available. You get an ETN, so maybe I could ship off a Clyde Edwards-Helaire for something like a Darren Waller. You know, if I need to make that trade, I can. And now we're sitting in a spot here at the 110 where we can go Bateman. We could go Mac Jones. Here's my take on Mac Jones. I really like Mac Jones, and if I was drafting in the NFL, I think I would have him in the same tier as these guys. If I was drafting in the NFL, I think I would have Trevor Lawrence at the 1, Justin Fields at the 2, and then the rest is up to interpretation. And I think I would have Mac Jones as high as like number 3. I think that Mac Jones, in terms of like a real life quarterback, is going to be sick, or at least he has like a really high floor. Think about him; he doesn't have nearly the same rushing upside as these guys. And if you've watched my top 5 lessons learned video, what I learned from last year is that your starting quarterback in fantasy can't run the ball, isn't a mobile quarterback, you're at a disadvantage. Of like the, if I can remember like the stat correctly, I think it was like the top 12 fantasy quarterbacks last year, like the top 7, 6 of them were rushing mobile quarterbacks. So Mac Jones was a guy that averaged like, I want to say like four rushing yards per game. It's all my rookie database I have. And then these other quarterbacks all have like 15 to 20 to 25. Those points matter. Establishes a floor, you know? And Mac Jones, his upside is more like a Kirk Cousins, like a Matt Ryan. Whereas a Trey Lance, he could be Josh Allen. Zach Wilson could be like Patrick Mahomes. Fields could be like a Russell Wilson, Dak Prescott. Trevor Lawrence could just be like out of this world. And he also has some pretty good rushing upside. Like I remember, I want to say in the national championship game, or no, his junior year against Ohio State, he had a huge run for like 60 yards into the end zone. He has wheels too. Now, so as much as I do need a quarterback, I don't feel pressure to force Mac Jones here. And I think I would just take my favorite wide receiver here, and that's Rashad Bateman. I have Rashad Bateman as my wide receiver 2 in this class. I think that he is clean. He is crisp. He's a stud. He produced as a freshman. He's done it every single year. We haven't seen the workout numbers yet on him, but I think that he is a really smooth wide receiver. Can play in the slot, can play on the outside. He's probably going to get first round draft capital. He's a guy that I really like. So we'll take him at number 10. If you're telling me that I could come out of my draft with Travis Etienne and Rashad Bateman at the 108 and the 110, I'm happy at that point. Now in this spot, we have Rondale Moore, Devonta Smith, Mac Jones, Terrace Marshall. I think of these four is what I'm looking at right now. And I am slightly tempted to go Mac Jones, but I think it's definitely for me between Terrace Marshall, Rondale Moore, and Devonta Smith. I will say, with the news of Rondale Moore measuring in at like 5'7", that is a little bit scary to me. Now, I know there's some people on Twitter out there that are like, oh, I have conviction. Like, if you liked Rondale Moore before, you should like him now. Look, when I liked Rondale Moore before, he was 5'9". Now he's 5'7". And I'm not double counting because I knew he was, because yes, he is small either way, but 5'7 really limits what we're looking at here. We're looking at like a Tavon Austin. I still think that he will be like a top 5 wide receiver for me. And I did came up on him like a couple of videos ago. I called him like a mini Saquon Barkley, which I do believe he's 5'7", 190, can squat 600 pounds. But I think if you're going to let me get, I think that I would end up getting Terrace Marshall here. It's very close to me between Rondell Moore, Devonta Smith, and Terrace Marshall. I would need draft capital. If Rondell Moore and Terrace Marshall both go second round and Devonta Smith goes first round, I think I go Devonta Smith. Which I'll do that for now because we don't have draft capital. In my rankings, I do have Devonta Smith lower than them, but if Devonta Smith ends up going first, there's no draft capital factored in on my rankings. If Devonta Smith goes first round and Rondell Moore goes second and Terrace Marshall goes second, I probably have Devonta Smith at wide receiver 3. So I'll go. This is a really tough decision. I think I'll go Devonta Smith. If he ends up going like top 10 like he's projected to, I'll go Devonta Smith. I think you can't go wrong there. So we come out of the first round with Travis Etienne, Rashad Bateman, Devonta Smith. I'm pretty happy about that. I feel like that's two wide receivers there. Oh, Terrace Marshall, he goes at the 205. Rondell Moore, the 202. These are two wide receivers that give me a lot of upside next to Ayuk, next to T. Higgins, next to LaVisca Chenault. And then I get a fifth locked and loaded stud at running back. Now with these next wide receivers, I think Elijah Moore is solid. He just had his pro day today. He ran like a fucking 4.35. He's somebody I'm going to be adjusting in my ranks for sure. Tylan Wallace is also a stud. Chuba Hubbard is really interesting to me. I think here the only two guys that I'm really looking at seriously are Chuba Hubbard and Dyami Brown. To me, they're neck and neck. Dyami Brown, I've even heard some buzz he might go late first round. Dyami Brown is really good out of UNC. I heard that he might have weighed in. He's supposed to be like 185, 6'1". I've heard that he might be like 200 pounds. He runs really fast. He's like one of the only wide receivers to average over 20 yards per reception in two straight seasons. And he did that next to Daz Newsome. He's done some really crazy things in the NFL. And as much as I do like Chuba Hubbard, I would rather have Dyami Brown in the situation I'm in right now. Because I don't need another running back. Like, I have plenty of running backs that are like Chuba Hubbard. I have, who can I point at? I have a Keyshawn Vaughn. I have a Joshua Kelly. You know, guys that aren't going to be immediate RB1s. Kind of have to build their way up in like committees and shit like that. So I'm just going to swing on another wide receiver. Because I really need a wide receiver one. I have Ayuk. I have Chenault. I have Chark. I have T. Higgins. None of these guys are top 12 guys. All of them have the potential to be, so I just want to keep swinging on that potential to be a top 10, top 12 wide receiver because I need that elite production there. So I'll go Dyami Brown because I do think that he is the best wide receiver left on the board right now and by a good amount. So we'll go Dyami Brown. Now the thing that sucks, I haven't addressed any of my needs. I need quarterback. I need tight end. And here's the thing. You can always just draft really good players and trade for your needs later, or you could even trade out of picks. Where are we now? So I'm on the clock at the 3-1 here. We have, Pat Freiermuth, he's kind of looking me in the face. Yeah, dude, I'm honestly pretty low on this tight end class is dope. I'm just low on taking them in the rookie drafts, to be honest with you. Like, you're giving me a hard time to pass up on Seth Williams, Michael Carter, Tamarion Terry. Tight ends, they're so easy to acquire. You can get just cheap ones. Like, who are like young breakout? You could get, who are like breakout tight ends for this year? I mean, you could get like a Mike Gesicki. You could get is there anybody else out there that I can think of off the top of my head that's like a breakout tight end candidate? Let me look at like, I'll just go to, there should be, yeah, so just like the, I guess like I'll just look at like the leaders and tight ends, but you could always get like, you could get like a Tanyan, you could always get a Mike Gesicki, a Logan Thomas, you know, a Hayden Hurst, a Jared Cook, he just went to the Chargers. Like, there's so many out there that you can just grab. You could also get Blake Jarwin, you could get an Irv Smith for much cheaper. And I guess not much cheaper, like the 301, we're not working with that much anyways. But if you're gonna, it's just, these drafts are so deep. Maybe I go with a Pat Freiermuth. Maybe I'm just in a spot where I should go Pat Freiermuth here. I would be more comfortable taking Pat Freiermuth like around here. Because I think I would still take Michael Carter. But I don't even like Kadarius Toney. But if he's going to go first round, I'd rather take Kadarius Toney, Michael Carter, Seth Williams, Tamarion Terry. And then that's end of list. I'd rather those four players. So I think because I go best player available, And in the real draft, I feel like I really am impressed. I don't think the rookie tight ends, unless you're talking about Kyle Pitts, the rest of them, they're not going to produce for you year one. So either way, I might as well just trade for somebody else that'll actually produce for me year one. And in this spot, I think I actually end up going Seth Williams. Seth Williams is a guy that is really getting slept on right now. I'll bring him up here. But he's a guy that I really like. I have him as like a top 10 wide receiver, but everybody else has him super late. If you're going to give him to me in the third round, I'll take that every day. He runs a 4.5. Oh, I love the player profile put his pro day number. But yeah, he runs a 4.54. Nothing crazy, but 6'3", 211, has that alpha profile, 4.54. Kind of looks like a T. Higgins to me. And he's produced every year. He produced in his freshman season. And he's never put up eye-popping stats like 1,000-plus receiving yards. But you have to remember, his quarterbacks have been Jarrett Stidham. They have been and Bo Nix. Those are two trash quarterbacks. And not only that, he's been alongside Anthony Schwartz, the guy who runs super fast out of Auburn as well. I think that once he gets to the league, if he can play on the outside and gets an opportunity, he could be this year's kind of like a Claypool, you know, kind of just like an outside clasher that, or like, I wouldn't use Gabriel Davis, but I think Seth Williams has a lot of upside as like an alpha type receiver. So I'm going to take him here. Yeah, I was waiting for that to fucking come down. I don't know why I couldn't digest that, but yeah, Pat Freiermuth goes there again. As pressed as I feel about tight ends or at my tight end spot in this league, I just don't think that any tight end past Kyle Pitts that you draft has guaranteed year one production. You know, we didn't see anything from Cole Kmet. We didn't see anything from Adam Trautman. I can't remember the last time that a tight end came into the league and gave you solid starting numbers where you could put him in. You could plug and play him every single week and not think twice about it. You know, like it's pretty rare. Now, are any of the guys that I mentioned, Kadarius Toney, Tamarion Terry's gone? So yeah, all the guys I mentioned that I was looking forward to are all gone. Now, I'm very interested in a couple of these guys here. I think I'm not really interested in Kellen Mond. Is there anybody else that... See, Anthony Schwartz is really interesting here. Anthony Schwartz is somebody that should not be all the way down here at all. Is Amari Rodgers still there? No. So this is where Amari Rodgers went. Ramondre Stevenson. I've been a big Ramondre Stevenson guy in the past, but if he's gonna, he right now ran like a 4.68 or something crazy like that, so I'm out now. Let me see. So Tamarion Terry, Tutu Atwell, that's interesting. Amari Rodgers, Marquez Stevenson, Demetric Felton. Man, I would say Dwayne Eskridge is really interesting. The thing about Dwayne Eskridge is like he's like fucking 36 and has two kids and a car loan, like. And I'm exaggerating, he's like 24, but a 24-year-old rookie, if you're already like 24, I'm just not sure what you can, like, your ceiling is pretty limited. I mean, you can look at like Terry McLaurin, you can look at Calvin Ridley as old rookies. Neither of them were 24 coming into the league. What other wide receivers? Pretty much so, Anthony Schwartz and Dwayne Eskridge. I would say I'm down to Anthony Schwartz, Dwayne Eskridge. Any of these running backs are interesting to me? Pretty much just Javion Hawkins, but not really that interesting without knowing draft capital. So I think I'm going to go Anthony Schwartz here. I don't know why he's so low, but this guy, he ran like a legit... I hate doubling up on Auburn wide receivers, but I don't give a shit. They're going to be on different teams in the NFL. It doesn't really matter. He's a guy with legit track speed. He's 6 foot 186. He ran a legit 4.32. He broke out his last year, so that's a little bit concerning. He did have some good special team yards at the end or at the beginning of his career. But he's a speedster. Why not take a pit? He kind of reminds me. I think Anthony Schwartz is like this year's Darnell Mooney, KJ Hamler type guy. He's like a down the field speedster. So we'll take him. Why not? And we'll end up with five new wide receivers and a running back. Obviously, these five wide receivers are going to be tough to keep. I'll probably have to make some moves. Like I said, I would have to make moves for a tight end, and I have to make move for a quarterback. So when you do a draft like this, and you don't really plan, and you don't really do by position, you have to bet on yourself to be able to make trades. And now I think that, you know, I got some ways with my words in the DMs, you know, sweet talk the lead mates into trades and shit. You just have to understand that these players in your team, as much as you do need position, it's dynasty. And trading happens so much. You have draft picks to trade with. You can make the moves. So go best player available and then make moves from there. You know, I can always turn one of these wide receivers. I can always turn... Now that I have all this youth and stuff coming in and I feel good about my wide receiver core, I can always turn a Christian Kirk, a Devontae Parker, and a first into a quarterback. I can take a, You know, I could take a Devonta Smith if I wanted to and get a quarterback. I could also, if I'm on the clock and I don't like anybody there, I say, hey, I want to trade this 112, get a quarterback. I can't exactly trade the picks here. So yeah, I honestly don't care that I ended up with five wide receivers and a running back. It's really not a big deal at the end of the day. Like I said, you can trade these players, but this is at the end of the day. This is what I came up with. I think this is a really interesting website to go out there and draft as if you had your own draft picks, you know, because if you go on a sleeper, you can only do the 106, the 206, the 306, the 406, whatever. So this is a cool way to do your own thing. Now, you can't have like buddies in this draft. It's just AIs. I don't know what they're working towards with this website, but I have it bookmarked. That's why you can see this little blue star. Made it this far, man. I appreciate it. Make sure you go down below, subscribe, leave a like, and make sure you join the Discord. It's only going to be like free for the next four or five people that join. After that, I'm going to close it off because I want it to be an exclusive community where only people that fuck with the channel, fuck with Dynasty, fuck with fantasy football in general are on that channel or on that Discord. So without further ado, follow me at @RonStewart_on Twitter. Okay. I'll see you guys in the next one.
Okay, baby be calling me Hercules, cause the H on my waist, but this bitch here stand for Hermes. Okay, I done pop me a perky, cause I heard it help with the pain, but just help my back aches. Okay, baby don't hurt me, let's begin after three, cause a nigga like foreplay. Okay, tripping like I just took a shit and clocked toilet. Captain Long John Silver.